Hi guys, if it's Tuesday, it's Down and Dirty Woodscraft. Stay with me. Okay, today we're going to talk about water. And more importantly, how to find water. As we're out doing our treks and our camps and things like that, quite often we're looking for water sources. So I want you to be mindful of how water sources come to be, and so you can look at topography and spot where the water sources are going to most likely be. Okay. Plus, once you get a big water source, we'll deal with that in a minute. So let me zoom in a little bit, and we're going to talk more in depth with that. Okay, first of all, let's start with, you have a layer that is the surface of the ground. And then you have repeating layers, like rings on a tree, layers on a cake, going down through the soil. When rain falls down upon the surface, it soaks in. And in doing so, like this, due to gravity, it will penetrate down through the layers, percolating, until it reaches a layer that it cannot go through for some reason. Usually that layer is called non-permeable, and that is where it builds up. Now the common term we use for this is, that's the water table. That's where it hits, and then it begins to spread out. As it does so, once it has achieved this, whatever direction is downhill, hydraulic pressure will want it to flow that way. Now, you have, let's say, get my stuff organized. All right, we have a layer. And that layer right here is impermeable. And right here, you have the water layer, the water table. Above it, you have all the other striations. As this water is flowing downhill, it erodes right here at the top. Because it can't erode or do much to this bottom one. It can, but it takes a whole lot longer time. But it can, that softer layer it percolated through. And as it does, this causes the ground to V down. As this center section is being removed by wiping the bottom, so to speak, and removing it from below. This creates the classic shape that we think of a surface stream, of a bank dropping down to a surface of water, just like that. So that's what forms the V that we see. So when you're standing here on the bank looking down, what you're actually seeing in the actual stream is a mere fraction of the water table that is being exposed. See? Now, in topography, you can also see this at elevations and things like that. But what we're going to talk about now is, I am coming down a ridge. And I, you know, in this process of this hike or whatever, and I'm looking for water, as I'm coming down, let's say, this ridge, I get to a certain point, and I find an area that looks like it ought to have water. There may be traces where water were there, but there isn't any. As I go downhill to the next one, I will probably find water here because this elevation is higher than this, and that water table hasn't quite broke it here, but it has broke it here. So, of course, going downhill is always the best way to look for water. But it also causes us to have the idea that water can emerge and disappear. Now what that means is, let us say, like where I was at here recently on Duggar Mountain, you have a mountain. You have a couple hundred feet down from the top, a non-permeable layer, like that. What happens is the rain that's going to be falling up here on top of the mountain will percolate down till it hits this layer. And then it begins to flow whatever the downhill is. So say like right here, you're gonna have the water emerge, maybe as a waterfall, maybe as a seep, maybe as just water running down rock. And it might run down a couple of hundred feet or whatever and then disappear back into the rock, because I may have a outcropping or whatever, so that as it's coming downhill, it hits a point of elevation. Like right here, say this elevation swells up or out, whatever. It can then re-enter, because at that point, here would be another water table it could enter into right here. So the water could be on the surface for a time and then disappear back up under the rock again. I've heard of a place in, I believe it's in Kentucky, in Boone National Forest, called Virgin Falls, where something like this happens, where the water comes out up high up on a mountain, falls a couple of hundred feet, and then disappears into a cave. That's it. There's no outlet. It's a big pile of water. That's where this water aquifer is pouring downhill to the next aquifer. Okay? Now, how this can apply very directly in our bushcraft is this. Whenever you find a river, a stream, a swamp, a big hunk of water, okay, and we're going to say that first off, we have, here is the bank coming up to the other side. And here in the center, we've got our water supply right here. But what if that water supply is kind of funky? There's a lot of stuff growing in it. It's got a lot of moss, a lot of scum, a lot of stuff. It's not stagnant, but there's a lot of crap in it. And I'm wanting to gather it as a water source. And I got a little bit of time. I'm not at a dead run. Let's say I'm going to be making camp next to this. Well, that's when I want to dig my own well, a coyote well. Now, since I've pointed this out to you, what you're seeing on the surface is merely the tip of the iceberg. That water may spread hundreds of yards in either way, but you're only seeing that 10-foot wide stream. See? Suppose I come up here, I'm not in rock, but I'm in a soil thing. I go up here, say, a couple of feet out of the actual water level, up here on the bank. I don't want black, sticky, nasty mud. I want soil. Sandy is better, okay? And let's say I dig down, about a foot, foot and a half, 2 foot. I come up here and I dig down like that. Hydraulic pressure from this water is going to force water into that hole. Right there, at the same level as the stream, because it's pushing outward at the same time. By digging down to that, I will hit the water table. I will hit that point where I start getting mud. I dig down a little bit deeper, make a hole about the size of my hat, you know, and I go back to camp and I start setting up camp. After about 30, 40 minutes when I come back, that hole is full of water, and a lot of that sediment I've now stirred up has settled, and there's relatively clean water. The longer I wait, the cleaner that water is going to become. And since this water has been forced hydraulically through the dirt, it's relatively clean. And so I can take that water to boil, or that water to filter. I could filter it out of my main thing, but I'm running the risk of clogging up my filter faster. I've got time. Why not just go over here and dig a little well to get to the water table and get cleaner water to begin with? Hope this gives you some ideas, guys. I've done this trick many times in the swamps and things like that, where I'd find a sandy area along the side of the bank, and I've dug down and got almost clear water within, say, 10, 15 minutes to flow into that. That's what I filled up my containers to go boil water when I got to camp. That becomes my well. If I cannot do any purification for whatever reason, I don't have the ability to make fire or whatever, and this water up here is scummy, I'll dig that well to get that water and drink that raw water if I have no choice, you see what I'm saying, but to drink raw water. That will be the water I'll do, the filtered one in that little bitty well I dug. Hope this gives you some ideas, guys. Please leave any questions or comments below. Until next time, I'm Blackie for Shaman's Four Woodscraft. Wishing you safe journeys. Have a great day, guys.